Hi, my name is Baby Buchanan, and I've just written a book, Bay and Her Boys, is my story about being a single mom. And it just was published this month. And basically the reason I wrote this book is I became a single mom over 20 years ago now. I had a 4-year-old, a 2-year-old, and I was pregnant with my third son. And it was something I had never expected. It just, you know, there I was, a single mom. I'd been raised in this great big Irish Catholic family, 7 brothers and a sister. And my father was so key to that family, and I thought I had the greatest childhood. And here I was, a single mom, and I thought, how am I going to give my kids the kind of great childhood that I had without having a dad in their home? And so it was a brutal time for me, very emotional, and I just worried about my children, and I felt I had failed them. And then I came to realize that, no, wait a minute, this is a new life that I have. I am a single mom, and I've got to be extremely positive about this. I've got to do everything I can to make certain my kids do have the kind of life I had. That's my responsibility as a parent. But what I found is that as I started recognizing I needed to get in charge of my life and I need to move on and leave all the past, the what ifs behind me, and really engage in this world of single moms, as I did that, I started hearing more and more reports and studies that showed that single moms can't be as successful or are less likely to be successful as other parents because the dad was so critical. And my friends would take studies and statistics to the television and radios and stations and make the case again that, look, here's the reports, here's the facts. A dad, you know, most single moms, their children being raised by single moms are 4 times less likely to fail in school, 3 times more likely to get in trouble with the law, much more likely to have real illnesses, emotional illnesses. And I thought, my gosh, how am I going to succeed? This is all they would say year after year. How important it is to have a dad. Dad is critical. That's what's key to the success of your children. That's the way kids thrive, is by having 2 parents in the home. And I thought to myself, is there no message for us? I mean, here we are, single moms. I agree dads are important. I don't argue that point. But surely we should, as a movement, as a conservative movement, care about the children being raised by single moms. There should be some message of encouragement for them, some hope, maybe some guidelines, some things they could do that would help their children to end up being the young men and women they're meant to be as well. And so as I went through those years, I started realizing there are different things you can do. And nobody, I just learned them just by accident or just because of the way the difficulties I was facing and the way I addressed those things. Or I saw a study and I said, hey, here's a little tidbit. And I pulled it all together and I thought, you know, we need to really encourage single moms. There's 12 million of us out there, 18 million children being raised by single parents today. We need to make certain that they succeed too. And so I wrote this book with that in mind. And it's my story. It's how I did it from day one, the day I became a single mom, right through. And I used my children to write how they felt about the divorce. And I talk about the importance of, if it was so important to have a dad in the home, I thought to myself, and I can't give it to them, maybe I'll do the next best thing. I will give them a dad in their lives. At least I will give them a chance to have a dad in their lives. It's up to him to do that. So I never badmouthed their dad. I talked about him positively, as tough as that was on days. And I gave him every opportunity to visit them. But then I knew I needed to compensate for not having a dad in the home, to teach my kids those lessons that other children are learning because of their home circumstances, but that mine would not. And I found role models, strong male role models for my boys in church, in neighborhoods, amongst my brothers. And I exposed them to good families where they could see how a dad is meant to treat their wife and how a dad should treat their children, how a man should treat his wife and a dad treat his children. So my kids got exposed to this as much as I could. And then I learned that the first thing you gotta recognize is you have to put the kids first. Everyone has a right to have one, to be first in somebody's life. When you're a single mom, you're the only one left. So I made certain they were first in my life, and I really learned what that meant when I became a single mom. I became a better mom. Every day I would just decide what's the best for the kids, what's best for the kids. And that's how I raised them, making those decisions. And then after that, I basically said, we need to create a home life. I need to make certain I cut down my expectations. I'm one person trying to do the job of two. So I call it, one chapter is called strict the parenting down to the basics, stripped parenting down to the basics. And I realized my mom had these wonderful meals she would serve. Three-course meals and homemade desserts. And I'd be lucky to have fish fingers and French fries on the table with my kids. But I said, don't judge I tell other single moms, don't judge yourself according to other people's standards. Create your own standards. What can you do? What is the standards that you have? What are the most important things you need to do? And then do those. And number one important is that you're with your kids. So don't be running around doing everything, cleaning house, making certain things, or just like your sisters or your neighbors. Be there with your kids. And I found that dinner, what was important is not what was on the table, was that I was there. That was key to them. And that's what I think is the story of single moms, is be smart and make certain you don't create some kind of a life where you're going to be the perfect mom. You're just going to be the best mom, the mom your kids need. That's all you need to be, is the mom your kids need. And make certain that that you spend time with them and create the great traditions so that they're always drawn to do things with your children. To you and your boys, as in my case, you and your children, and that is what is critical, to create that strong bond, sense of security in your home, a place that they know they love to be. Single moms can have a blast. It is so much fun to be part of your family when you make it that way, and you enjoy your children, and that's key, not to get overwhelmed, and just to be there with them, and that's what the book's about. It gives you 8 rules of single parenting. It goes down each one. I tell lots of great stories about my children, and very funny stories about how mistakes that I made, how the mistakes they made, and the lessons they taught me, because being a single mom made me not only a better mom, it made me a far better person.